The Jeff Fox Radio Show.
And welcome back to the Jeff Fox Show right here on Rep Yo City TV with my man Fisher Grits on the ones and twos back there. Of course, you know we are all about the home team. Yes, we are, and we got none other than our very special guest who represents the 305 like none other. This is my man Abebe Lewis from Circleized. Welcome. Jeff? We got to do this now.
How you doing?
We got to do this.
That's what we got to do, man.
We can't shake hands. You know, we can't chest bump and all that old school stuff.
Definitely, definitely. Big Jeff, how you doing?
Great, man. Great. Definitely. I was looking forward to this interview, man.
Definitely.
Because you are an interesting guy.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Yes,
so,
sir.
So they say.
And nobody, again, I wasn't just saying that for introduction purposes, folks. This man represents like none other down here in the 305. Everywhere I go, when it comes to entertainment.
Yes.
And whether it's hip-hop, R&B, whatever, people ask me if I know you. There are two people. Seriously, Fish, wherever I go, they want to, do you know Uncle Luke? And do you know Abebe? You have made quite a name for yourself.
Yeah, I tried, man. You know?
Yeah.
A lot of mistakes, a lot of experiences to get to this point where I'm at in my career, and I really feel that, you know, I'm at a point right now where I'm kind of like definitely understanding my power, you know what I'm saying, understanding the gifts that I have, and, you know, I would like to share them, you know.
Yes. You come from a rich background in music.
Definitely.
Inner Circle, we played the video earlier, Bad Boys. You know, that's a strong legacy.
It's very strong.
And your father, a member of Inner Circle. Talk about what it's like, the pressure of having such a legacy to live up to.
Well, it's a lot of pressure, man, because every day you get up and, like, you just, you know, your dad got movies and soundtracks and people sampling the song, and it's just, like, you got to live up to something. But it's, like, it was a little different with me and my father because, like, I was there with the struggle with him. So I was there catching the bus to the studio with him. I was there watching him engineer and watching him do different things. So I was, like, somewhat I was a part of the success of the song because I saw it blossom, you know what I'm saying? So, like, the pressure is definitely on to now continue that motion and continue that movement. And with a great family I got behind me, like my little brother Lunch Money Lewis, who's a huge songwriter, who's writing so many hits out there. He has gold and platinum records that he has on his own.
Give me the green light, cause I'm ready to go. Let's have a good time. What you waiting for? You only got one life. We gon' live it up.
It's just amazing. My little sister, she just graduated from SCAD Academy. She's all into acting. She's in Atlanta right now doing her thing. So it's great to have that cast around you that, you know what I'm saying? It's a family business. I got my uncle, I got my dad. Like, we all been with each other for like 30, 40 years since I'm only 34.
Okay. He said he's only 24.
Folks. Yeah, 24, 24, 24 ladies, so, 24.
So, I mean, you've seen what it takes
to
achieve the ultimate success.
100%.
I mean, Inner Circle is about as big as it gets.
Yes.
You know, we've seen the Bad Boy movies.
Yeah.
Bad Boys, the TV show Cops.
Everything.
You saw it from the very beginning.
Yes,
as
I
you
did.
Said earlier.
Yeah. That was actually like the first reality show ever.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It was ever, and it was so crazy because where the first Circle House was in Broward County. And it was so funny. One day we came outside the studio and they were actually pulled somebody over and was filming right in front of there. And I was like, wow, this is, you didn't put two and two together and understand that 25 years later, this thing was still going to be keep going and going like an Energizer Bunny, you know? Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, again, and then over at Circle House, man, you can see anybody from Chicago. Everybody's been there back in the 90s, Cash Money Millionaires.
Yeah.
You name it, they've been there.
Yes.
So you weren't exactly, you're not someone that's going to get overwhelmed by being around stars. You've been around everybody.
I've been around some of everybody from Mariah Carey all the way down to, you know, Birdman, Lil Wayne. I've seen all those guys blossom, Jay-Z, Damon Dash, Rockefeller. You know what I'm saying? I'll tell you a funny story, not a funny story, but a heartfelt story that when Aaliyah actually plane crashed, she was on her way to Circle House because they were at Rockefeller was at the studio with us and she was coming to finish the record, you know what I'm saying? So she was actually on her way to Miami to come to the studio, man. So, you know, God bless her soul, you know.
No doubt. We're talking to Abebe Lewis, of course, from Abebe Lewis Branding and marketing company.
Definitely.
Now, this is something that you created
definitely
for you.
Definitely.
Why?
I just saw their need, you know, because honestly, people don't know a lot of things about me, that I was a producer first, a beat producer. If you look on Trick Daddy's first album, I produced 4 songs, along with Red Spider and Hugo Diaz, which is the brother of Luis Diaz, which is the big-time engineer. So back in the days, we didn't have Instagram like you kids have. We didn't have TikTok. We didn't have that. So it was all about the streets. It was all about word of mouth, your flyers, your poster game. So I had to sit back to myself, do I want to sit in the studio and make beats my whole life? Mm-hmm. And it's hard to promote it. It's hard to get those beats placed. But I try to sit back now and I says, hey, let me learn this marketing game, you know, and learn how to take my dad's and my brother's and everybody's music like to the next level, and other products and different things. And it's worked out for me in the best way, because nowadays, if you don't know marketing, you don't really know nothing, especially with COVID, you know, COVID got going on, you know?
Yeah, COVID's taking over. It's a different world we live in.
Different world.
You know, I got my mask and again, it's been tough for a lot of people, man, you know, dealing with this pandemic. You kind of have to reinvent yourself, haven't you?
Definitely had to reinvent myself, but I went back to my old school ways. Mm-hmm. Some of the things I did was, like, you know, I went back to my email marketing. People told me, oh, email marketing is done. Man, nowadays, when I do an email blast, I'm getting 50,000 more opens than I would get, because now people are home. They're looking at different things. That whole old school press release way, wait for the newspaper, all that game is done. It's all about guerrilla marketing. And when I mean guerrilla marketing, I mean things like Rep Your City TV, where this man got his own channel. He's giving you guys a platform to come up here as a single business owner or a politician to come speak your mind. You ain't getting on David Letterman. Won't you come rep for Fish and Rep Your City TV? You know, it's what you got to do, you know?
No doubt, man. We're very happy to have you again here on the Jeff Fox Show. Spitting game.
Yeah.
Educating people.
Yeah.
Because they need to know. And as a marketing person and marketing exec here in South Florida, your client list is pretty nice.
Yeah.
I mean, you go back to the Two Live Crew and Inner Circle.
Yeah.
That's a great place to start.
Well, like I tell people, it's all about your catalog. You know what I'm saying? And once your catalog is there and your catalog is tough, Inner Circle has a tough catalog. Girl, I'm Gonna Make You Sweat, Bad Boys, Games People Play, Two Live Crew got hits, Pop That Coochie, Me So Horny. Like, these records will never die. They're part of they're part of like folk history. It's just to take those records and keep reinventing them and you know, just knowing what's going on with them. And, you know, God rest Betty Wright's soul. She's not my client, but like, I want to help out. So if the family's listening, man, I would love to help y'all to reinvent that catalog, just to make sure Betty Wright's catalog stays where it needs to be. She has so many hit records, man. It's all about those cataloging your music, you know, and owning your music.
Right. That's something a lot of young folks need to know about.
Yes.
BB, you also come back from that rich partying history of South Beach. You've lived it all. You've done it all. You've been at all the major parties.
Yeah.
Headliner.
Yeah.
What was that experience like for you? How much does it help you? Like?
Well, it helped me a whole lot, because my first real event was with my boy Michael Mad. You know, we did a party called Miami Live. Man, I think that was before The Forge on Sunday. That was before Live. Was the biggest party in Miami. I mean, Lil Wayne must have performed there about 50 times for us for free. Coolio, man, Digital Underground, Neo, Brian McKnight, man. This was a party where the whole concept was you never knew who was going to hit the stage. And I miss parties like that. I miss events like that. I love going to the event where, you know, it's hosted by blah, blah, blah. You already know what it's going to be, but it's like no mystery to it. It's no edge to it, you know. But you still have fun in those things, don't get me wrong, but I'm a different person. I like concepts. I like a story. You know what I'm saying? That's what I like about, you know, the innovation, you know?
Mm-hmm. What would you like to see change about the music industry, the entertainment industry right now?
Well, just people working together more. Like, if we're going to be in Miami and we're all whirling to Miami, I think I want to see more unity. I want to see an album called Miami. You know what I'm saying? On that Miami, I want to see everybody on that album, right? We can take that profit and we can give that to a charity. It's not about the money. It's more so about showing unity. And what people don't understand, when you show unity, other things will come. We have so many dope artists, from Ball Greasy to Trina to this new girl I'm working with now, Diamond Doll, Legacy. You got independent companies like Dark Boys Records, who I'm working with, who's heavily funded. These people are good people, but it's all about the connection point and everybody working together. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna say it again. My man Fish got Rep Your City TV. Come come vibe with him. Come mm-hmm. come put your stuff on the video. Come with a concept for him. Come buy some airtime, because the bigger he gets is the bigger platform that we can all put our stuff on, and it's Miami stuff, and it's our stuff, you know?
No doubt. And of course, very happy to have you here,
no
man.
No problem.
Because there are a lot of young kids that want to get some game. They want to get in this music business. And it's hard for them sometimes.
Definitely.
To get motivated. What would you say to an up-and-coming artist right now if you were to look at that camera and speak directly to that artist?
I would say it's so many free platforms they have right now. You have TikTok. You have Dubsmash. You have Instagram. Now Instagram got Reels. You got Facebook. Learn how to monetize your music and come with a business plan. You know, like I told my daughter, man, she's like 13 right now. I say, any guy you come date, you need to come with a five-year business plan. You know what I'm saying? So if you don't have a five-year business plan for my daughter or any type of business you're coming at, you're doing it all wrong. You know what I'm saying? Nothing's going to happen overnight. I don't know if you guys believe in this overnight success, but I don't. You know what I'm saying? When you see an overnight success, it was planned for 2-3 years or very intricate move, chess moves. You know what I'm saying? But come with a business plan for 5 years, stay consistent, and watch your life change. I guarantee it.
No doubt. And of course, we also want to find out from you, what it takes. You've been doing it for so long.
Yeah.
To get up every day and still do this. It's got to be some kind of love.
Yeah, it's love.
It's a crazy love that's inside your heart.
Yeah.
Fish has it. I know I have it doing the Jeff Fox Show.
Yeah.
It is something that drives you. What drives Abebe Lewis?
It just to wake up and see innovation. You know what I'm saying? To see what's next, to see what's new, and try to learn it, because there's so many people getting wealthy and rich with not even having to deal with the record companies, mm-hmm. with not even having to deal with anything, who's selling and sitting in their bedrooms and selling $10,000 worth of merch every day, products, different things. It's just an understanding, and it's just so much knowledge to learn, and it can get overwhelming, and you just gotta keep the right people around you, and thank the Lord. Like I commend my dad every morning. He calls me in the morning like, "Get up, man! What you doing, man? Get up." So, you know, he's in his 60s, and he called me getting up. I'm like, man, I need to get up. This man is 60 years old telling me to move, to be innovative.
Right.
He's telling me about TikTok. He's telling me about all these Instagrams and these websites and all this stuff. So I'm like, wow. Like, you know what I'm saying? So I got a good set of people around me, you know, to really keep me motivated and keep me on the right track. I make mistakes now. Don't think I'm a perfect person. I'm far from a perfect person. I make so many mistakes, but I try to learn from my mistakes, you know?
Mm-hmm. Talk about some of the artists on your roster, not the two live crew, Inner Circle.
Yeah.
Who are some of the new people you're working with?
Well, I'm working with Dark Boys Records. I'm consulting their record label. They have a new artist called Diamond Doll, which also she has a new single out right now. Of course, you know, everybody knows the Tory Lanez, you mm-hmm. know what I'm saying? It's called Automatic. Legacy's on there too. She has a whole EP dropping right now. And another artist called Legacy, which is an R&B guy. You know, he's about to drop at the end of the month also too. But one thing I like about Dark Boy Records, they are in it for the long haul. During COVID, we must have shot about 15 different music videos, and just because content is now king. Without mm-hmm. content, you don't have nothing. You can drop a single on the radio. I'm in the business, and I'm in these big meetings. These people are not even going to radio first anymore. They're going straight to TikTok. They're going to YouTube. They're going to digital radio, which is your Sirius satellite radio. There's so many digital radio stations now that give you BDS spins. You know what I'm saying? It's not just radio, you know? So it's like, and it's more, honestly,
it's online
radio, right? And it's BDS, and it's international spins.
Right.
So when you get a spin on an online radio station, you don't know where people are listening to it. It could be Italy, it could be Japan, it could be Europe, it could be America, it could be Dade County. You know what I'm saying? So those is so many stations like that to get to before you even get to your 99 Jams or your Power 96 or your Hot 105 and your Miami radio, you know?
So with that in mind, the music business has certainly changed a lot.
100%.
Should be a lot easier now when artists coming out compared to the old days.
Compared to the old days, it's a lot easier because you have a lot more channels. Like, right. we had no channels. Like, we had 99 Jams. My dad told me to go there and knock on the door. He got his vinyl in his hand. You know, he's trying to see Mr. Russian, man. Mr. Russian, can I see you, man?
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? It was different. Where now, it's so many stations. There's so many concepts. There's so many things to do. There's influencer marketing. There's people dancing to your song. Or you can go find out some crazy stuff. That's why I said it's all about innovation. And what people don't understand, the hotter we make Miami is the hotter for everybody.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, support your Rep Your City TV. Support the Heat. Support the Dolphins. Support the Marlins. Because the bigger we make these things, is more people coming to our city to spend money with us. You know what I'm saying? So that's what people don't understand. We make Miami a bigger place, you know, to be more successful for everyone to profit, you know?
No doubt. And that's why we, on here on the Jeff Fox Show, we try to bring 100% all of our local heroes,
yeah,
like yourself, into our fold, because we got to get that message out there.
Yeah.
See, Atlanta has this great reputation,
yeah,
that they support their local artists.
Mm-hmm.
Here in Miami, are we getting there?
We're getting there somehow, but I think the more, if the stations and the television see us working together more, they got no choice but to work with us. Mm-hmm. But if they see us not working together as a unit, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
They're gonna be crazy. So if we all hop on a one song, or we do a compilation together, and then they don't support it, then hey, it's time to get mad. You know what I'm saying? But if we all work together on a compilation and we release songs and everybody's vibing together, they're going to have to vibe with us. You know what I'm saying? Because we can create our own. That's the greatest thing about this new innovation of technology.
Right.
We can create our own stuff. We don't need them like that. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
We can create our own stuff, but we have to have a following. We have to work together. We can't be over there and over there and over there. We have to stick to it. You know what I'm saying? I guarantee, if all you independent artists call Fish up, call Jeff up, get on this show, blow this show up, this could be one of us in the park where everybody got to come back to this show to show love. They got to come back here, and we're sitting here breaking artists, breaking records right on this show. But it needs support, you know? You cannot, you know, it's got to have support, you know?
I love how your passion comes out.
Yeah.
As you talk about this stuff,
yeah,
I can see it.
Yeah.
You know, and it's a genuine love that you have for this city.
Mm.
And I think that's one of the reasons a lot of people come to you.
Yeah.
Because of, number one, your past experience,
mm-hmm,
and your know-how.
Yeah.
You know, and that's very, very important.
Yeah.
Going forward with this pandemic, COVID has taken over. What is the new approach now?
To
going out there and putting yourself out as a company,
yeah,
as you know, Abebe Lewis branding and marketing,
yeah,
what's going to make you different from the next people?
Well, it's just my innovative ideas that makes me a little bit different, but I'm getting into a lot of different things. I'm getting into food and restaurants. I'm getting into merchandising. I'm getting into television. I'm getting into cars. I'm getting into beauty products. I'm getting into bathing suits. I'm getting into some of everything to turn myself into that, like that mogul conglomerate, alcohol. Like, you know what I'm saying? I got an alcohol concept coming so crazy for y'all, y'all not even ready for it, you know?
Yeah.
Y'all not even ready for it. I'm planning every day. I'm planning. I get up and I plan. I spend 4 or 5 hours planning. I get up at 5 in the morning. I don't get up at 2 in the morning. I don't get up at 7 or 8. I get up at 5 o'clock in the morning and my day is moving already. And it's catch me if you can. When you waking up at 9, I've been up for 4 hours already. You know what I'm saying? I'm back home from the gym, or I'm back home from a meeting, or I'm from social media. You know what I'm saying? Early bird gets the worm, man. You know what I'm saying? Time is key. Time is money. Remember that.
No doubt. Put your information out there, man. Let everybody know how they can get in touch with you.
Well, you can get in touch with me by, you can follow me on IG at Abebe Lewis, which is Abebe Lewis. And when you go there, all my information is there. Or you can go to my website, ALMBG.com. But my Instagram has my cell phone number. I'm not trying to hide from nobody. I don't owe nobody no money. You know what I'm saying? All my stuff is right there. My email is right there. You can DM me. You know what I'm saying? And if you know, you know where I be at. You know what I'm saying? If you know, then the entire Miami know where I'm at all day. You know? So I'm not hiding from nobody. But like, I'm gonna say it again. All you Miami artists and new Miami artists, support each other. I'm telling you, it'll go so much of a long way in the long run, and you will see a change. I guarantee it, you will see a change. You know?
I love those words, man. He's Abebe Lewis, of course, from Abebe Lewis Marketing
and Branding.
And branding, of course, and branding is so important.
Definitely.
You know, keep sending that message out there, man.
Yeah.
You know, continued success to you.
Yeah.
Thank you for coming through, man.
No
right
problem.
Here on the Jeff Fox Show.
No problem.
All right, Abebe Lewis, everybody. You're watching the Jeff Fox Show right here on Rap Your City TV.
Rap Your City.